Jurisdiction, Part 3, MTC. We are done with letter A, the classification of jurisdiction, as well as letter B, the doctrine of hierarchy of courts and the doctrine of continuity of jurisdiction. If you are new to my channel, just go to the playlist. Yung discussion regarding these two topics are in the playlist ng Remedial Law. So in this video, what we are going to discuss is the jurisdiction of various Philippine courts. If you read the syllabus issued by the Supreme Court, ang sabi doon, you have to study the jurisdiction of the regular courts. Question, what are the regular courts? Answer is MTC, RTC, Court of Appeals, and the Supreme Court. These are your regular courts. Also, included in that syllabus is you have to study also the jurisdiction of the special courts. What are the special courts? You have the Sandigan Bayan, the Court of Tax Appeals, and the Family Courts. These are your special courts. But take note na hindi lamang ito ang mga special courts. Meron pang iba. Like your military court is a special court. Also, your Sharia court is a special court, but these are not included in the coverage. Kaya huwag pag-aralan ang military court at ang Sharia courts. In this video, what we are going to discuss is the jurisdiction of the MTC. Your MTC is sometimes called the Court of Limited Jurisdiction, Inferior Court, or the First Level Court. Yan ang ibang tawag sa MTC, kaya wag malito, they are all referring to the MTC. Before we proceed, I want you to take a look at Section 27 of your BP 129. If the first level court is located within Metro Manila or located within the National Capital Region or NCR, ang tawag is Metropolitan Trial Court. Take note ha. You call it Metropolitan Trial Court. Kaya sa legal ethics, if you will be asked to prepare or to draft an information for less serious physical injuries and the crime happened in Valenzuela City, dapat sa caption pa lang, huwag nang magkakamali. Dapat ang isulat is Metropolitan Trial Court at hindi Municipal Trial Court. Huwag magkakamali kasi masakit sa mata on the part of the examiner. Also, in your remedial law, common question is, where are you going to file the case? Which court has jurisdiction? So, if the case is an action for unlawful detainer and the property is in Manila, you will write there, as counsel, I will file an action for unlawful detainer in the MTC of Manila. But hindi pwedeng isusulat lang ang MTC. You really have to spell it out. So when you spell out MTC, it is not Municipal Trial Court of Manila, but Metropolitan Trial Court of Manila. I highlighted Navotas, Malabon, and Pateros. Take note ha, take note, especially those coming from Visayas, from Mindanao. Kahit dito sa may mga Isabela, Mountain Province, minsan you are not aware that Navotas, Malabon, and Pateros are within Metro Manila or within the NCR. Kaya ang tawag sa courts nila is also Metropolitan Trial Court. For cities outside Metro Manila or cities outside the National Capital Region, like for example, Surigao, Iligan, Lucena, Cavite, ang tawag naman sa first level courts na mga to is Municipal Trial Courts in Cities. Take note ha, Municipal Trial Courts in Cities. That is very clear according to your Section 29 of BP 129. Dapat yung mga ganitong detalye, small details, dapat very much aware kayo dito, especially if you are taking the bar examinations. Dapat conscious kayo sa mga proper terms kasi meron kang mga makikitang mga examiners, lalo na yung mga matatanda. They are not forgiving when it comes to these mistakes. So be careful. The name is Municipal Trial Courts in Cities. For other first level courts, ito yung hindi situated inside the city or inside the NCR, you call them municipal trial courts. That is very clear according to your Section 30 of BP 129. So aside from Metropolitan Trial Court, the Municipal Trial Court in cities, and the Municipal Trial Court, we also have Municipal Circuit Trial Court. That is very clear according to Section 25. Kailan nagiging Municipal Circuit Trial Court? Usually, kinocombine nila dito dalawang municipalities, maybe because of the population, maliit, so pagsasamahin na lang. And according to Section 31, there shall be a Municipal Circuit Trial Court in each area defined as a municipal circuit. A municipal circuit comprises of one or more cities and or one or more municipalities. Example is the one in Cebu, but not within Cebu City. The one in Santa Fe or Bantayan Island, there is a municipal circuit trial court there. So let's go now to the jurisdiction of the MTC. We're going to find out ano ang ODESCA ng MTC. What is the original jurisdiction, delegated, exclusive original, special, concurrent, and appellate jurisdiction of the MTC? Take note ha that the MTC can act as an environmental court. That is very clear according to the rules of procedure for environmental cases. Section 2 is very clear. Si MTC together with the RTC, they can act for civil cases, criminal cases, and even special civil actions involving enforcement or violations of environmental and other related laws, rules, and regulations. So ito yung mga batas na under ng environmental law. 2012 Bar Exam Question MCQ number 75, the MTC, acting as an environmental court, has its original and exclusive jurisdiction over the following except letter A, criminal offenses punishable under the Chainsaw Act, letter B, violation of the NIPAS law, letter C, violation of the mining laws, and letter D is the violation of the anti-pollution laws. So, ito yung mga bar questions na masyadong unfair, no? Kasi for sure, kunti lang ang nakabasa. But this is where your deans come in. Sila dapat ang magtatanggol sa inyo over this kind of bar question. So, if you go back to Section 2 of the Rules of Procedure for Environmental Cases, kasama ba ang Chainsaw Act? Kasama, that is number 22. How about the NIPAS law? Ano ba itong NIPAS law? That is number 13, the National Integrated Protected Areas System Act. That is your NIPAS law. How about the mining laws? Mining laws is also included, the Philippine Mining Act, number 15. And for anti-pollution laws, you have the Clean Water Act, you have the Clean Air Act, and then you have the Oil Spill Compensation Act. So, ano ang hindi kasama? The answer here is letter A. That is the criminal offenses that is punishable under the Chainsaw Act. Because if you're going to read the Chainsaw Act, the penalty is imprisonment of 6 years and 1 day to 8 years or a fine that is not less than 30,000 pesos but not more than 50,000 pesos or both at the discretion of the court. So, since the imprisonment is more than 6 years, definitely si RTC na ang may jurisdiction and not MTC. Going back to our ODESCA, we are now in letter D, the delegated jurisdiction. So, ano ang delegated jurisdiction ng MTC? Section 4 of RA 7691 has the answer. Section 4, by the way, amended Section 34 of BP 129. So, there are two cases. First is cadastral or land registration cases covering lots
where there is no controversy or opposition. Take note ha, dapat walang controversy or opposition. Ito lang ba ang pwedeng i-delegate ng Supreme Court to the MTC? Answer is no, kasi pwede rin ang land registration cases or cadastral cases na merong opposition as long as the value of the lot does not exceed 100,000 pesos. How do you determine the value of that contested lot? You determine it from the affidavit of the claimant and if there are two or more claimants through their agreements. At kung walang affidavit, walang agreement, then you can determine it also from the tax declaration of the property. Take note that the MTC here will be acting as RTC. Therefore, if you are not happy with the decision of the MTC, you can file your appeal. But where do you file your appeal? Since it is acting as if it is the RTC, then you file your appeal to the Court of Appeals. Take note of that, ha? How about letter E of the ODESCA, that is the exclusive original? Exclusive na, original pa. Exclusive meaning to the exclusion of all other courts, and original meaning the MTC will be hearing the case for the first time. So, Section 33 of BP 129 enumerates the exclusive original jurisdiction of the MTC. But take note that Section 3 of Republic Act 7691 amended Section 33 of BP 129. Isa-isahin natin sila. So for your civil actions as well as probate proceedings, whether that is testate or intestate, including the grant of provisional remedies in proper cases, you determine the value. You have to take a look at the value of the personal property or the value of the state or the amount demanded. Bakit? Because if you are in Metro Manila, dapat the amount should not exceed 400,000 pesos for the Metropolitan Trial Court to acquire jurisdiction. Since you are in Metro Manila, dapat the court wherein you are going to file your case is Metropolitan Trial Court. And if you are outside Metro Manila, like for example, you are in Baguio, you are in Iligan City or in Tacloban City, or even in the municipalities of Santa Fe, Bantayan Island ng Cebu, dapat the amount should not exceed 300,000 pesos. If I were you, dapat ang isusulat nyo is does not exceed 400,000 pesos or does not exceed 300,000 pesos. You used what is written in Section 33 kasi pwede din namang isulat nyo sa mga booklets is it should not be beyond or it should not be more than 400,000 pesos or less than 400,000 pesos. Correct din naman yon. Pero you used the terms indicated in Section 33 and the term is it should not exceed, does not exceed 400,000 pesos, does not exceed 300,000 pesos. Mas magandang tingnan on the part of the examiner. Before I proceed, let me just remind you of number 2, pag probate proceedings, what is the procedure that will govern? That is regular procedure. Lahat ng probate proceeding, kahit ang amount involved ng estate is 100,000, 50,000, 150,000, 199,000, hindi yan sinasummary procedure. Dapat ang procedure that should be applied is the regular procedure. Next, you take note of dialect. Kasi ang dialect, ini-exclude yan and ini-include. Take note ha, kailan mo i-exclude si dialect. By the way, dialect stands for damages, interest, attorney's fees, litigation expenses, and cost. You exclude dialect when you determine the jurisdictional amount of the MTC, and you include dialect if you're going to file your filing fees. Again ha, exclude dialect if you are going to determine the jurisdictional amount, and you include dialect if you're going to pay now your filing fees. What else? Remember your real action. Ano ulit ang real action? If the case involves Title II real property, or it involves possession of real property, or any interest in that real property, that is a real action. At pag real action yan, ano ang kailangan mong tandaan for MTC to acquire jurisdiction? You have to know the assessed value of that real property. Because if you are in Metro Manila, the assessed value of that real property should not exceed 50,000 pesos for MTC to acquire jurisdiction. And if you are outside Metro Manila, the assessed value of the real property should not exceed 20,000 pesos. Remember also your dialect in determining the jurisdictional amount of the MTC. You exclude dialect, but you include it in the filing fees. Paano naman kung hindi mo alam yung assessed value kasi hindi naka-declare? In that case, what will the court do? The value of that property shall be determined by the assessed value of the adjacent lots, yung mga katabing lupa. What else are the cases wherein the MTC has exclusive original jurisdiction? Answer is forcible entry and unlawful detainer. Nakasulat yan. That is number 2 of section 33 of your BP 129, but you already know that. But ano ang kailangan tandaan? MTC may jurisdiction sa lahat ng forcible entry and unlawful detainer, but regardless of the amount, ang procedure that will govern is not the regular procedure, but summary procedure. Again ha, si MTC ang may jurisdiction, pero kahit si MTC ang may jurisdiction, hindi yan regular procedure. Lahat ng cases ng forcible entry and unlawful detainer, regardless of the amount involved, dapat ang mag-govern na procedure is summary procedure. As early as now, dapat pag pinag-uusapan si forcible entry and unlawful detainer, dapat pumasok na sa utak nyo tong kinds of recovery of possession. There are 3. You have action interdictal, action publisana, and action reinvidicatoria. Kailangan alam nyo na to as early as now because it will affect the jurisdiction of the court. Because if it is action interdictal, that is your forcible entry and unlawful detainer, MTC has jurisdiction. And if it is action publisana or action reinvindicatoria, then you have to know the assessed value of the property because you can file it either in the RTC or the MTC. Sampulan natin para mas madaling maintindihan. 2017 bar exam question number 1, letter A. So ito yung mga questions na dapat tama agad ang sagot kasi this is number 1. It will not leave a good impression on your examiner kung number 1 pa lang malina. So what trial court outside Metro Manila has exclusive original jurisdiction over the case which is an action filed on November 13, 2017 to recover the possession of an apartment unit being occupied by the defendant by mere tolerance of the plaintiff after the former ignored the last demand to vacate that was duly served upon and received by him on July 6, 2016. So what is the answer here? The case that you are going to file is an action publisana. Bakit naging action publisana at hindi action reivindicatoria and action interdictal? You take note, what is the basis of the recovery of the possession? Is it based on ownership? Hindi, kasi tinolerate lang ni plaintiff ang pag-occupy ni defendant. Second is the date. kailan nagkaroon ng dispossession? Did it last already for more than a year? In our bar question, answer is yes, kasi ang last demand to vacate nga, the demand to vacate was received by the defendant on July 6, 2016 and final lang yung kaso November 13, 2017, so that is more than 1 year. That is the reason why the case is action publishana. But since it is outside Metro Manila, what is the jurisdictional amount for your real action? The jurisdictional amount is, it should not exceed 20,000 pesos of the assessed value of the property. Assessed value of the apartment unit in the case of our bar question. So MTC has jurisdiction kung ang assessed value of the apartment unit does not exceed 20,000 pesos and RTC if it exceeds 20,000 pesos. Take note ha, since you are going to file the case outside Metro Manila, therefore, it's either municipal trial court in cities, it's either municipal circuit trial court or municipal trial court, but definitely not in metropolitan trial court. Take note of that, yung mga maliliit na mga, ito yung mga conscious ka dapat sa mga proper terms. What else for your action for exclusion of voters? An action for inclusion of voters, MTC has jurisdiction, exclusive jurisdiction over these cases. That is very clear according to your Section 49 of the Omnibus Election Code. And for your cases which falls under the rules on summary procedure, again, si MTC, na-discuss na natin yung summary procedure, just watch the video. And for your small claims cases, lahat ng cases under the small claims, MTC also has the jurisdiction. So going back to our ODESCA, tapos na tayo sa original jurisdiction, delegated, exclusive, original. So we are now in special jurisdiction. Section 35 of your BP 129 is very clear. Merong special jurisdiction ang MTC. But before we go into that, recall first this slide. We said that Supreme Court, Court of Appeals, and RTC, they have original jurisdiction over your petitions for habeas corpus. Take note ha, although they have original jurisdiction, since it is shared with other courts, therefore, concurrent jurisdiction din sila over petitions for habeas corpus. But in cases where lahat ng regional trial court judges is wala in a province or city, that is the time that the MTC can exercise special jurisdiction over petitions for habeas corpus. Take note of the condition ha, dapat absent ang lahat of all the RTC judges in a province or city. Kailan ba nagiging absent ang lahat ng judges ng province or city? Siguro nag-attend ng seminar, pinatawag ng Supreme Court, merong convention for all judges. So that is the time that they are all absent. So in this case, MTC can hear and decide petitions for habeas corpus. Take note also that hindi lamang ito ang merong special jurisdiction, ang MTC. For your application for bail in criminal cases, MTC also can decide on this case as long as the condition is met in the province or city where the absent regional trial court judge sits. Down to our last slide, a judge of an MTC can hear and decide petitions for habeas corpus or applications for bail where choices are Letter A, the Supreme Court authorizes the MTC. The judge is the executive judge of the MTC. The judge of the RTC where the case is ruffled has retired, was dismissed, or had died. And letter D, in the absence of all the RTC judges in the province or city. So the answer here is letter D. Yung kadidiscuss pa lang natin, yung special jurisdiction of the MTC. Marami pang ibang questions regarding jurisdiction, but I will make a separate video pagsasamahin ko lahat ng mga questions ng jurisdiction because your jurisdiction is a favorite topic in the bar exam. Parang kulang ang bar exam ng remedial law kung walang tanong sa jurisdiction. So we are done. Natapos na natin. We tackled the original jurisdiction, the delegated jurisdiction, the exclusive original jurisdiction, as well as the special jurisdiction of MTC. Yung concurrent jurisdiction, pag binasa mo yung mga memory aid, walang concurrent jurisdiction ang MTC. But if you look at the environmental, the rules of procedure for environmental cases, we already read that yung section 2, si MTC and RTC has jurisdiction. So in a way, they shared that jurisdiction for environmental cases. Take note that walang appellate jurisdiction si MTC.